I start off by saying, man, it's lovely to be a car hauler. Like I say, places I deliver to, I get to get food like this. I had food like this in the area. But you a reefer driver, or I don't know about y'all flatbed dudes, but all y'all reefer drivers doing them warehouses and all that, I don't got stuff like this in the area, man. It can't compete. That's all I'm gonna say. I got the beef and broccoli popping. You know what I'm saying? I eat like this for dinner. Making excuses, man. And the reason why I say that is I been a truck driver, I always run into that dude, and for all my truck drivers out there, y'all know what I'm talking about. I always run into that dude that be like, yeah man, I hear y'all truck drivers make a lot of money, woo woo. Yeah, I was thinking about getting into it. Thinking about getting my license. Like, they always hit you with that, I was thinking about. So, you know me, I just try to encourage people, you know what I'm saying? I don't be trying to judge, show off the rip. My first response would be like, oh yeah, you should do it. You know what I'm saying? It'll change your life. Some money in it. Get you some money. Like, there's money to be made for real. Once you get your experience and stuff like that. So then, that first instance when they say, yeah, I've been thinking about it. Like when they hit you with that, that's a semi red flag, but not really a red flag kind of, cause you know what I'm saying? There's nothing wrong with, you know what I'm saying, doing your research before you jump into an industry. But that'd be semi red flag. Then they usually come back with it. Yeah, how long you be hard to stay out though? That's kind of like another red flag, semi-red flag, not too bad. But then this be the kicker. Man, I ain't really trying to go out of state though. That be the big red flag. Like, what you mean? You tell me if a person say they gonna pay you X amount of dollars to leave the state, you're not gonna do it just cause you don't wanna get from up under your girl, or you know what I'm saying, can't leave the, you know what, the ussy. Can't leave that cat alone, let's go get some money. Like, and most of the dudes that I talk to about this or come at me about this, it's not like they making good money, or they not, it ain't like they working a six-figure job or nothing like that. These dudes be like, it ain't no knocking nobody, cause like before I got in the truck industry, I was working a bunch of day-to-day jobs. I was working McDonald's, like temp agencies and all that type of stuff. So you gotta, you know what I'm saying, do what you gotta do to get where you're trying to go. But these dudes be like working at the gas station, working at fast food spots, places that, you know what I'm saying, paying like minimum wage, and be like oldest on the world. They be like in their mid to late 30s, 40s and stuff. Got gray in their beard and all that. I'm like, bro, stop thinking about it and get out there. Yeah, I be trying to encourage people, like, yeah, just do it. Thinking about getting in the truck, just do it, bro. Do all the little research you need to do. Ain't nothing wrong with that. I'm one of the type of people that do my research before I drop it or something, so I don't blame you. But just do it, man. Like, it's definitely gonna make more money than working at a gas station or working at a fast food spot. And then, like I said, there's so many. See, the thing about truck, it ain't that. The thing is, it's not that truck drivers make so much money. That's an opportunity. For one, it's like so many different niches inside of trucking that you can get, that you can make money from. Like I said, for one, it's the opportunity to start your own business. It's that opportunity to be independent, be entrepreneur. That's the aspect of being the middleman. You can broker loads. You know what I'm saying? There's so many different niches as far as driving the truck too. Like, you got car hauler, refrigerated, dry van freight, you got flatbed, you got heavy haul. There's so many different, different ways to make money in the truck industry besides just driving. So, man, just made this video just tell people to stop making excuses, man. Stop making excuses, man. Get from up under your girl, because she's gonna love you a lot more when you bring home that money. It'll be a transition at the beginning. You know what I'm saying? Everybody go through that phase when they first get in trucking. Hey, girl, missing them. You missing your girl. Away from home, missing your kids if you got kids. And then everybody get accustomed to the lifestyle and then become the norm. And it's not as bad. A year later, it ain't as bad as when you first started. I run into these type of dudes all the time. I mean, I still try to, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to put nobody down, nothing. I still, every time I run into them, I try to encourage them, like, yeah, you should do it. You should really do it. But they don't never give off that vibe, right? They're at the point in their life where they're really ready to do whatever it takes to better themselves. They still be talking like they're dragging their feet. Stay for this one. First, I'm gonna say, y'all can't eat like this as a flatbed. Yeah, I'm gonna say flatbed, dry van, reefer. None of y'all don't eat like this when y'all pocket y'all shippers or receivers, because y'all don't got spots like this in the area. Y'all have warehouses and all that. So, yeah, that's a shot right there for y'all. Bang, bang. Other than that, stop making excuses. 2018, get the money. Yeah, I'll holler at you.